I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making deluxe tuna salad. I call it deluxe because it has a lot of ingredients. Usually tuna salad has about five, and that's tasty and that's nice, but this is some variety to bring into your life. You need to start with a large bowl. I have a clear bowl here, and into that bowl we're going to put tuna. And I use the tuna that is stored in water, and you can use the other kind. Either way, you need to drain it. So in the sink, you just put your hand over the opening there, press, and let that water that's been storing the tuna, let it run off into the sink. So you'll do that on two cans. It doesn't matter what brand you've chosen. I've just got a store brand that goes with Kroger. If you want something a little different, just look around at your grocery store and there probably will be a few brands. But they all come down to this. It's tuna stored in either water or oil and then drained and scraped out so you get as much as you can of it, and then you can move on to the next step. The next step is adding in some vegetables, some eggs, and the mayonnaise that I mentioned, and some herbs. So I'll just get started on that. Here we have two eggs, freshly boiled but allowed to cool, and they've been peeled and chopped. So two is the number. And I'm just using this cutting board as a vehicle to move the boiled eggs. You don't really have to measure if you're doing whole eggs, which you chop, of course. I think that's good enough. So we'll go on to our vegetables. The first thing I have here is 1/2 cup of chopped celery. And that should be fairly fine. You don't want to have large pieces of some type of vegetable to chew on. So 1/2 cup of chopped celery, and chopped fairly fine. Next, we have dill pickle, and that's 1/2 cup, chopped fairly fine, about the same as the other. And the next thing I have in line over here, I have some purple onion, and this is 1/4 cup. Finely chopped purple onion. A lot of people call that red onion. Same thing. Here we have canned tomatoes. It's canned and put in a glass jar. This is 1/4 cup, and it's chopped the way it came from the company that made it, but it is fairly fine. And then our row that's closer to me, here we have paprika. This is 1/2 teaspoon. This is an easy salad to make because all of these things are measured out and then each one individually gets transferred to the mixing bowl. Here we have 1/2 teaspoon of cilantro. Next, 1/2 teaspoon of thyme. And these last three were dried herbs. We have very few herbs left in our herb garden, but I think you'll see one when I serve this up. I have all the things except the mayonnaise. So I think we've got everything that needs to be blended except the mayonnaise. So you can see what it's beginning to look like. Let me work on this, get it all together, and I will include the mayonnaise and then come back. So I put the mayonnaise in, and I decided that the best proportion would be to have you put in 1/2 cup to 1 cup of mayonnaise. You need something to bind it together like that. You might choose a salad dressing if you prefer that, but in general people use mayonnaise. So we've got our mixture here. It should be about like this when you stir it. Not dry all the way, but not wet. So we're going to spread up some sandwiches, and that will be our lunch. After stirring in the mayonnaise, then you might want to put your salad on toasted bread, or you might want bread that's not toasted. Here's what I've chosen. I like this brand a lot. It is Pepperidge Farm, and this happens to be sourdough flavored, and it is nice and sturdy. I've opened up this package, so I'll show you what it looks like. It's in between white bread and whole wheat in terms of texture. So you can just pick what you like. You can toast it or leave it untoasted. I decided to toast ours for lunch here, and I went out to the herb garden, even this late in the year, and got some parsley to garnish it. So that's our lunch. Along with it, I have some green tea that is the brand Bentley's. I'm going to do my taste test and see if I'm going to enjoy lunch. So I'll just pick up one of these, and I don't necessarily eat the parsley that I put here. It's mainly for garnish and color and texture. So here we go with the sandwich. Lots of different flavors. And you may know the sourdough bread is just a little tough compared to white bread, so be prepared to chew a little bit. So I think I'm going to take this over to the table and put my whole plate together over there and look at the nice sunny day with birds and all the Kentucky things you can imagine. It will be pleasant with this sandwich.